In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to work with the actual dynamic effect tables. In other words, the tables that create the math that dynamic effect templates use to create the shapes we see on stage. As a reminder, we'll take a quick look in the templates list. Again, very simply looking at a circle, for example. You notice this column called table. The table is where the math comes from. So if we look at the list of tables, when I open this up, the first one is actually a stop table. It's a way to make a parameter stop moving. Sine wave, step, sawtooth, ramp, an inverted ramp, or ramp inverted in this case, mark on, mark off, spiral, tangent, and then a number of additional types of math that are designed specifically to create specific kinds of color or movement effects in the system. Thus the kind of strange non-mathematical names like Harlequin and Flames. These tables are built into the system. There's a lot of them. We're going to take a look. But you can also make your own, or you can make adjustments to these tables. Please be aware, the deeper you go into the system, if you make changes in here, for example, you're changing what a clockwise circle is going to look like from now on. If you go into the dynamic table list and make changes, you're changing what a sine wave looks like from this point on. So please edit carefully in these areas if you're going to play a little bit, just because a small change in a table of the math could affect your effects later on in ways you don't expect. But let's have a look anyway, because we're living dangerously. The dynamic table list is right under dynamic tables in the browser. This is the only way to get into this particular list. And we're going to open that up. And now you can see, once again, it's just a table full of names. These are all the names of the tables that are in this system. And tables are just numbers in this case. And it's going to be what numbers are defining the path of the curve or the step or the wave or whatever you want to call it to be used inside these templates in order to create the shapes that we recognize later. Most of the basic ones, and there are a number of basic, you find them in sound consoles or sound systems a lot, these different type of waveforms, they're already in the top list. So if you're thinking mainly in these basic type of forms, you don't have to build them, they're already in there. It's when you want to do something very customized or something kind of wacky that you might come in here and make your own table. But we'll look really quickly here at a very simple one. So here's step. And I'm going to open that up. And you're going to see that the step table has four steps. Full, full, zero, zero. We count in a 0 to 255 range, because that's the highest resolution of any 8-bit DMX channel. And in this case, it's a step, meaning that we want it to be at zero, and then step up to full, and then step back down to zero. So it's a very square wave type of thing. When you're seeing these multiples, right, 2 times 255 or 2 times 0, what that's doing is it's stretching the step out. As opposed to a momentary flicker on off, which would be zero and full, this one's going to elongate those on-off steps a little bit so they're more pronounced in the wave. So I hit escape and look at the main table again. So we know that the step wave is 2 times on, 2 times off. Interpolation is turned off. That means that the system will do 0, 0, full, full, and it will snap from 0 to full and then from full back to 0. That's creating the square wave, these very sharp cliff-like steps between levels. The sine wave above that, though, has interpolation on, and that's because a sine wave wants to have a nice smooth curve, right? It's going to fade from the middle point up to the highest point and then back down to the lowest point and then back to the middle point, and that's going to create one sine wave. So in this case, interpolation is turned on to help smooth the movement of this table, but it also means I don't have to put in 255 steps of data when I write it. Because a sine wave, you want to have as many points on the curve plotted as you need to get the smooth movement, but you don't want to go insane typing in 255 individual points to get you through that curve. So you can see here we've got 32 points defined, interpolation is turned on, and instead of jumping from 80 to 104 in this case, it's going to step through in a smoothed out version. If you are incredibly detail-oriented and you wish to ask me, how do I know how fast that's going to happen? I can't answer that question for you. but you have all of these rate functions, size functions, et cetera, that allow you to play with these waves and stretch them and compress them in order to get the type of look on stage that you want. There's simply a lot of variables, how fast the light moves, how big the distance is the light has to move, and all that sort of stuff that can cause that interpolation span to be different based on all of those different variables. But anyway, these are the points that you need to hit in order to create something that looks like a sine wave. And just for fun, we'll take a quick look down here at Morse, for example. This is another step type, but you can see just how many points you can actually start entering in order to create customized looking curves. Morse code, dot dash, that sort of thing. So you can see repetitions here of multiple 255s, individual zeros, double zeros, triple zeros, that sort of thing. That's going to create this stagger or stutter step that mimics a Morse code message, for example. So it's not just on off, it's on off in random combinations for as long as you wish to keep typing. In this case, it's 64 steps. So you can be as detailed or not as you choose to be, depending on what it is you want this curve to be. And in this case, because it's dots and dashes, it should be a bit steppy. Interpolation is turned off. If you turn interpolation on, it's going to give you a fadey, weird-looking sort of intensity thing, or linear, rather, effect. There's nothing that says that this is an intensity effect, by the way. Strobe, a lot of off and a short blink on, that sort of thing. Some of these tables are specifically meant for specific parameters, like strobe is probably going to happen on intensity, but a lot of these others don't have to. They can be used on any parameter in the system. And then to make your own, of course, scroll to the bottom, hit insert, and start typing in numbers. Be warned, do not change, please, the basic ones you see in this list, because they can have ramifications later on during your show. So play in ones that you start from scratch and go from there. And that is the basics of creating a dynamic table. The dynamic table is a wave or a math table, a series of values that you apply to a parameter in the dynamic effect template. And then you use the dynamic effect templates on dynamic effect playbacks with lights to create the effects on stage. And that is everything you need to know about dynamic effects in Cobalt. Thanks.